Step 1. The FLSun side should face the QR code side. It's important. Now this is the QR code side, but there is a switch on this side which is going to come like this and get pressed. So I'm going to keep it a little like this. You see, the table is ending at that point, so the switch is not on the table. Next, we will have to take this arm with Y stepper. So this is the Y arm, and the stepper motor will go to the FLSun side. There are Y cables inside which will be connected to the stepper. So after placing all the screws, let's move on to the next axis. Now for the next axis, check out the wires, and here it shows X axis. Okay. Connecting the X axis wires for the stepper. Okay. Now it is connected. After assembling all the three axes, now on the FLSun side, this cable will be inserted here, okay? Not this side, but here. Next, take the cable out from the other side and connect it to this point, the stepper motor. These two will not be connected yet. Now place it vertically as shown and get ready for connecting these pieces. Also look if there is any dirt available in the slots for just in case. There is an ant here. Now comes this part. It will face like this. Now comes the connection part. Now guys, there should be a white wire coming out from this side. Okay, if not, then you will have to open up this side, the upper top. So that's the inside view. Here you see the stepper motors, and that's the white wire I was talking about. Okay, after doing that, place the cap back as before. After that, connect this filament holder.
Then set the supply voltage at the base according to your country voltage. Leveling switch. So guys, talking about the FL-Sun V400, I got the printer. It was quite heavy, it is huge, and the assembly was very easy. Like, I didn't need any YouTube tutorials for that. All I did was looked into the assembly manual, and that was it. I did it. Next, we all know about the speed of the FL-Sun V400. It is superb. Like, I was very surprised when I saw the V400 running so fast that I could barely focus on the extruder. It was so fast. And as far as the power goes, it is 450 watts. Plus, the time consumed in the printing is also going to reduce a lot because the printer is high speed. Next, there is one con that I didn't like about this 3D printer, which is no recovery after power outage. If we talk about the software, the clipper, you can remotely operate it and check its operation on your mobile phones or your laptop or PC, whatever you have. Next, the magnetic bed. That is also great. You don't have to use any other tool to remove the 3D print. All you got to do is lift the magnetic tape and it's going to remove your print. And the lights, the extruder lights. The extruder lights were one of the most important things that were added by FL-Sun. And many printers don't offer that kind of lighting. It is really important for vloggers and YouTubers for illuminating the print area. And you can easily understand that. So I think that's all for the pros and cons. And see you in the next video. Bye-bye.